I'm Hurst Kaufman.
And I'm Linda Lloyd, and we'd like to take you on a tour of Ottawa.
In the heart of Ottawa's business district is the Franklin County Courthouse. It has served the area for more than 70 years. Adjacent to the courthouse is the county jail and the city police station. And across the street is the Chamber of Commerce.
The United States Post Office in Ottawa transferred to this new location in the fall of 1964. The new modern office provides quick and efficient delivery. Forming the hub of Ottawa's government activities is City Hall. A recent addition to the Ottawa Fire Department is this aerial platform snorkel truck.
Since 1929, Ransom Memorial Hospital has met the medical needs of the community. Across the street from the hospital is the new Medical Arts Building. Ottawa's senior citizens have access to fine nursing homes.
Carnegie Free Library is a place for quiet study and reading enjoyment for all Ottawans. The building was made possible in 1903 by a grant from the Carnegie Foundation, and the 23,000 volume library is now supported by city taxes.
Memorial Auditorium was built as a World War I memorial. The headquarters of the Franklin County Humane Society are the animal shelter. The Southwestern Bell Telephone Company provides telephone service for Ottawa and the surrounding area. Radio station KOFO, located south of the city, broadcasts both AM and FM throughout the heart of eastern Kansas.
One of the leading daily newspapers in Kansas is the Ottawa Herald, which publishes 25 area newspapers from its offset press.
Thank you. is the Kansas State Employment Service.
And this is the local office of the Kansas State Highway Patrol.
The United States National Guard Armory is located in the southwest portion of Ottawa. The men of Ottawa are active in local service and fraternal clubs.
The Ottawa Country Club Golf Association provides various kinds of social recreation for golfers and their families. The clubhouse, restaurant, and pool highlight the club's recreational facilities.
Located in the heart of eastern Kansas, Ottawa is at the intersection of several major highways. Among these is Interstate 35, which will connect Duluth, Minnesota and Laredo, Texas with four-lane highway when completed about 1970. By using Interstate 35, Ottawa is less than an hour away from a major international air terminal and the navigable Missouri River.
Look, we're just in time for a train. You know, railroads have played an important part in the development of Ottawa. Both Santa Fe and Missouri Pacific Railroad lines have depots here.
Ottawa's public school system includes four elementary schools: Eugene Field School in West Ottawa, Garfield School in South Ottawa, Hawthorne School in East Ottawa, and Lincoln School is in North Ottawa. Also, the Sacred Heart Parochial School.
Ottawa Junior High School is housed in two adjacent buildings in the heart of the city. Completed in time for fall classes in 1966, Ottawa High School is located in southwest Ottawa. Its new facilities provide modern educational opportunities for its students.
Ottawa University has kept pace with the growth of the city. It recently celebrated its centennial. Chartered in 1865, it has grown into one of the most prominent private colleges in Kansas. Ottawa is also close to Baker University and the University of Kansas.
Churches play an active part in the activities of Ottawa and the surrounding communities. 38 churches representing many denominations and faiths greatly enhance Ottawa's beauty. Downtown, I'd like to try on a new coat.
By the way, I could use a new sport jacket.
Ottawa certainly has many fine stores for quick and easy shopping. The business district is constantly expanding.
Yes, and this is made possible because of the many outlets for building needs. Ottawa Steel Products, located in the north part of Ottawa, produces truck and construction equipment. It is a division of Paul Hardman, Incorporated.
Distributing dairy products throughout the nation is the Bennett Creamery Company, which began in 1902 as an ice company. The creamery, producing butter, Dairy Queen mix, ice cream, and other milk products, is one of the oldest and largest industries in this area.
Buildex Incorporated produces lightweight aggregate, which is a form of heated shale. By railroad and truck, this raw material is shipped to plants which make it into lightweight cinder blocks and other construction material.
Bruce Company Incorporated, a branch of H.D. Lee Company, produces overalls, industrial jackets, western jackets, and jean jackets from the new, modern plant southwest of Ottawa. The H.D. Lee Company distributes its products in clothing stores nationally. Corporation makes women's clothing, which is sold in their retail stores throughout the nation.
Baldwin Ward Manufacturing Company is the world's largest maker of sky hooks. Pepsi-Cola Bottling Company bottles many refreshing soft drinks for Ottawa and the surrounding area.
Another plastic industry is Parmalee Products Incorporated. This is a branch of the third largest eyeglass frames and safety glass companies in the world.
Star Mobile Homes is a division of Difco Wayne Industries Incorporated and is the world's largest producer of mobile homes, school buses, multi-stop delivery trucks, hearses, and ambulances. Delivering its products in 15 states, the Ottawa plant is ranked number one in quota among the other 15 mobile home plants. The Difco Wayne plant is located in Ottawa's Industrial Park, which is 122 acres set aside northeast of the city for industries wishing to locate here. It has a railroad siding, a circulating water line, sanitary sewer, and all types of electricity and gas.
The City's Service Gas Company provides fuel and power for Ottawa homes. The city has owned and operated its own electricity and water system since 1906. The municipal plant replaced a privately owned plant.
The recently completed Meritazine River Flood Project protects Ottawa from harmful flood waters. The project has tamed the river, which has been a menace in Ottawa's history. Another part of the regional flood control and water preservation project is Pomona Dam and Reservoir. The reservoir is located 16 miles west of Ottawa, and it provides a steady flow of water for towns along the Meritazine River. It is also a favorite spot for summer activities.
Ottawans love recreation. Thank you. near many camps and camping areas, including Camp Chippewa, a Methodist camp, Camp Kivawood, a Girl Scout camp, Mears Park, and the Pomona Reservoir camping areas.
The Dietrich Centennial Cabin and the Old Depot Museum are projects of the Franklin County Historical Society. These museums provide a showcase for fragments of Ottawa's heritage.
As we have shown you, Ottawa is steadily progressing upward and outward. The area has had many new industries, developments, and changes. With this spirit, Ottawa can and will grow.